For the people that did not see my last video, I am in the middle of a tiny little hallway makeover, and this makeover is starting to lead a life of its own. I decided to take this opportunity to do a little bit of soul exploration, and I'm probably going to be rambling on for a bit, but bear with me because it is all going to make sense in a minute. And then we are going to do some creative projects. But first, I want to share some thoughts that are in my mind right now. In my home, I always tend to keep things very minimalistic and very toned down and very peaceful and quiet. And the reason for that is because my mind is not peaceful and quiet at all. And it is not a negative thing, it is a very positive thing. And I think it is a luxury problem because my mind is full of creative ideas. And all of those creative ideas also come with a plan, because usually it means that it is something that I want to create myself and I need a plan for that. And it is very crowded in my head with lots of very interesting things, but it can be a little bit exhausting. And I think that's why I always try to keep my surroundings very quiet and very peaceful, because otherwise I get a little bit overwhelmed. I believe that your home should be a reflection of who you are as a person. My personality is not very minimalistic and toned down. I love adventures, I love challenges, I love diversity. But what I love the most is freedom. I think from the day I was born, I had one goal in my life, and that goal was to be, and still is, to be free. And this counts for every aspect of my life. So it should also count for how I live in my home and how I design my home around me. I always tend to stick to two colors, white and one other color. Before I had any houseplants, my whole house was a combination of blue and white. And then I started to collect houseplants. In my mind, the blue and the white and the green was just too much to handle. And I changed everything into white and green. I also always want everything to match. And by doing those things, I am very limited. And if you think about it, I am not free at all. I put so many rules on myself about how I want my home to be. And this is just to keep my mind quiet. And is it working? Not at all. If you look behind me, you can also see that I found a few more things in the trash. I did it again. I just look outside my window and there it is. And then I go out there to check it out and I say, hey, little cute thing, I think you should come home with me. And this frame that I have behind me, let me see if I can grab it. This is the perfect example of me limiting myself, because I really, really love this frame. I do not think that it fits in the style of my home. So my first reaction is, I like this frame, I'm going to take it home, I'm not going to use it because it doesn't fit with everything else. I'm just going to find a new home for it. And I was already thinking about Rogier's farmhouse. It would fit in his farmhouse. But this is where I am limiting myself. I like this frame, I should use it. Who cares if it doesn't fit anything else in my home? If I like it, I should use it. So that's what I'm going to do. And I have a plan with this. Of course, all of the ideas, they come with a plan, like I told you before. But first, I want to take a look at the cabinet, because I did some work on it. And I want to show you where I am at with the whole cabinet situation. And I have a few nice little DIY jobs that I want to do today. Hush little doll and don't say a word, I'm gonna buy you a mockingbird. Say, darling, say. And if that mockingbird don't sing, I'm gonna buy you a diamond ring.
Yes, and I know that diamond ring. Yes, I know that diamond ring is gonna shine. Darling, if you'll marry me, I'll buy you a house with a big old tree. Say, darling, say, we'll live in the house with a big old tree. Yes, and I know.
So I am working on this cabinet already for hours and hours and hours. It is not easy. The paint is not the problem. It is the layer that is underneath it. That's why the paint is not sticking to this cabinet. So that's what I have to remove. It is just so much work to remove everything. Am I really going to put another layer of paint on it? I can hardly use my hand anymore. My paint scrapers are not sharp anymore. And I am running out of sanding paper. So I need to see if I can get my hands on some more sanding paper. And when it is all finished, I'm going to sit down. I'm going to take a look at it. And then I'm going to decide what I'm going to do. I still have to do a little bit of the top. And I have to do one of the side panels. And then all the paint is gone. I am not in love with this cabinet right now at this moment. And just when I was ready to do the last little bit, my heating device is overheated, and sometimes that happens when I use it a lot. It just needs to cool down a little bit. It is too warm. It is just a safety mechanism that it has. When it gets too warm, it shuts down. Oh, it is working again. Maybe my grandchildren will laugh about it one day. Look at grandma, look at what she did. Look at how ridiculous she is on YouTube. So this is where I am at right now with this cabinet, and I have to say I absolutely love it. I decided that I am not going to paint it. I am going to give it a very, very good sand. Sanding paper I will have tomorrow. Just when I was feeling the need to feel like a queen, I found myself a throne. This is the perfect chair for the blue and white farmhouse bedroom that I am working on at Rogier's place. I was looking for a chair for that room, did not find one yet. And this morning I looked outside my window and there it was. And I'm excited about this. I'm excited about this chair. When I sit in this chair, I really feel like I am sitting on a throne. It is a fixer upper throne. I have this fabric and I had this for a while now. This is a typical Dutch thing. It is called Beyers Bond. You have this in all kinds of different colors and you are supposed to do embroidery on this fabric. That is what it is made for. When I ordered this fabric, I also ordered a book, and in that book you have all the stitches, the typical Beyers Bond stitches, and you also have all kinds of different patterns that you can make. So the plan is to do some embroidery in the middle of this chair. I have this yarn. This was also something I ordered together with the book and together with this fabric. I think this is so nice for this bedroom. It is so typical Dutch, and I think it is going to be lovely. This morning I also received some mail, and this is my wallpaper, and we need to open this box. We need to see what is in it. I am nervous about this wallpaper. I had wallpaper in my hallway downstairs before, but it was blue and white. After a few years, was not looking so nice anymore, so when I changed everything to white and green in my house, I decided to remove it. I do know that it looks nice to have wallpaper in there. So we have glue. Because without glue, there is going to be no wall with wallpaper. It is not as extreme as I was thinking. It feels like a very nice quality of wallpaper. Now when I take a look at the combination of all the things that I have over here, the minty green box, the art with this frame, this cabinet and the wallpaper, and then of course we also have this handle. This is the handle that the most people voted on to use for this box. I think this is a lovely combination. This could work, but as soon as I bring in this painting over here, I do not like it that much anymore. I think all of these things together could turn out into something very, very artistic. When you design a space, and it doesn't matter if it is a very big space or a tiny little space like my hallway downstairs, I think the most important thing is to be flexible and to be okay with changing your mind, especially when you are going to work with things that you find in the trash. You can plan everything ahead into the smallest details, but if you stick to that and you are not open to changing your mind and to changing things up, it is going to take away from the creative and the artistic process that designing a space is supposed to be. This is the part of the video where you can see me working very, very hard. Do you see it? No? That's because I did not film anything. And let me see if I can drag myself up. Up, up, up. I put up the wallpaper, painted the floors, minty green, sanded the cabinet. Also, I bought myself some very cute, very tiny little cacti because they are not going to die when I am not here. And I am gone a lot. So buying cacti, very sensible. Am I forgetting something? Yes, the wooden box is also painted. I just need to attach the handle. So we need to do a tiny little hallway tour because it is finished, not decorated yet, but finished. So let me gather some things and by magic, it is all going to appear behind me. Because I already made this footage before I removed everything, but you cannot know that. And then I'm going to show you all my artistic things, design visions and such. This is how the cabinet looks right now. I gave it a very good sand, but not too much because it is a very, very old cabinet and I think it is very nice. Like this. It has a very nice rustic feel and I love it so much. I gathered a few things on top of this cabinet just for me to see if I would like it. I have these beautiful feathers over here. I am definitely going to use them when I start decorating. And these are two of the little bottles that I found in the trash. This bottle has some bark in it. This is something that I use to make tea from. I think I need to order a little bit more because I am almost finished with it. And this was the little bottle that I showed you before. I have a very old box over here. This has some medical instruments in it. But I mainly just really like the little box. And of course, I have the frames over here. This drawing was originally in this frame, the frame that I was not planning to use. This passepartout was already in here. I just turned it around. So this is the backside of the passepartout. And this drawing was something that I already had. And I think it fits very well with the nature slash forest theme that this drawing has. This was made by somebody that was called Edward. I really tried to decipher his last name. I could not. I even downloaded an app on my phone with a magnifying glass to see if I could read it, but I just can't. And it was made in 1887. And this is not an original, but I do think that it is very old. And in some strange kind of way, I really, really love it. I'm so happy with it. I think it is very original. It did not fit this passepartout very well because it was very damaged on this side. So that's why you see a little bit of a stripe over here. But I guess that's the artistic part of things. I just had to fit it in somehow, and this is just how it turned out. This frame, the outside of this frame was painted black mixed in with gold. But this was so badly damaged that I decided to paint it. And what I did was I used a little bit of the minty green and I mixed it while it was still wet with some gold paint. And I think it actually looks old. It turned out so great and I love it so much. I'm saying I love it a lot, I know, but this is just how I feel. So I'm very happy with this little collage of things that I have over here. I cannot wait to start decorating. This frame is going to be in the middle, in between the two little windows, and this frame is going to be above the cabinet. When it comes to the cabinet, I decided not to use anything like wax or oil or varnish, because I like it so much the way it is right now. It does mean that I cannot put any plants directly on top of this cabinet because it is going to get water stains. But I do have the box over here. And of course, this is going to be on top of the cabinet. So if I want to put some plants over there, I can put the plants on top of this box. I found myself the tiniest, wobbliest little table to use. These are the cacti that I bought. Two little guys. I think they are so cute. And one that is slightly bigger. The containers that I have over here, this one is a very nice fit. These two are way too big, but it is the only thing that I have, so I guess it will have to do. I do think that these colors look very nice together. So for now, they just have to live in here. And who knows what the future will bring when it comes to tiny little cacti containers. Just plop it in there. And then basically we are done. That was the fastest little houseplant job ever. I also still do not have any cactus soil. So I have to be very, very careful when I'm watering these tiny little plants, because otherwise I am definitely going to kill them. It looks a little bit ridiculous having these tiny little cacti in these very big containers, but I think they just have to grow very fast if they want to look pretty. So let me take these little cute plants somewhere else, and then maybe we can put the handle on the box. Very easy, and I also slipped with my screwdriver, so I have a tiny little bit of damage over here, but I will fix that, me being a perfectionist. Using old screws is very nice in combination with an old handle. I do think that this is very cute together. The only thing that I am missing right now is a little saucer for the spot over here. And besides these little guys over here, of course, I also have a lot of other cacti that I can use if I want to. Probably it sounds very echoey in here because everything is still empty and very boring, but this is how the wallpaper looks. Putting up wallpaper in a very old house can be very tricky because nothing is straight. And these windows look straight, but they are not. They really go a little bit like this. They are all over the place. And that's why I put some painter's tape on the wallpaper, and you have to test it on your wallpaper first to see if your wallpaper can handle it. But most wallpapers can. And after that I caulked it and I painted it straight away. So when the caulk was still wet, I used some paint, and after that I removed the tape immediately. And I think having those clean lines really makes a difference between a job that is okay and a job that is very, very nice. I think the floor turned out great. I am very happy with the color. The only thing that I am not happy about is that I decided to paint this little edge over here green. I already gave it a little bit of a sand because I decided that I am going to paint it white. I also gave my windowsill another paint job because it was a little bit damaged in some areas. I painted the walls, and I also decided to order some curtains for that opening over there. And you see a tiny little thingy up there. That's where a curtain rod normally goes, because during winter I always have curtains over here. But the curtains that I have are very plain and white, and I decided to order myself something that is a little bit different. So I'm looking forward to hanging the curtains and putting up the art and all the other decorating things in here. So this is how my tiny little hallway looks right now. Let's snuggle up for a bit because I am cold. I actually have been sick all week. And today my doctor prescribed me some antibiotics. But I have to wait until Monday until I can get it, because it is weekend right now and the pharmacy is closed. It was a little bit of a struggle for me to get everything finished this week, but I still managed to do the whole DIY part of the makeover, so I'm very happy about that, because this means that now I can start decorating, and of course this is the nice part of the whole project, so I'm looking forward to it. The most important realization that I had this week is that I really love to connect more to my artistic side when I'm decorating my home. Sometimes you have homes that are full of random things that do not fit together at all, but then in some strange kind of way it all works out. And I would love to have a home like that, a more eclectic and artistic home that fits me very well. And I think by doing this little makeover I gained a little bit of knowledge about myself, about how I would like my home to be. So I'm definitely going to apply all of those things when I'm going to do my living room makeover. I am already applying some of those things when I am ordering things for my living room makeover. There are still things arriving in the mail. I ordered some crazy things. Some very interesting antique and vintage things. And I cannot wait to show you all of those things. But first, I have to decorate my little hallway, and after that I will definitely make the unique antique video, and I think it is going to be a lot of fun. I think all of this is going to be a very interesting learning process. I really need to learn to stop thinking too much and to stop matching everything too much. I really tried to do that with this little tiny hallway makeover, but I am still learning. I want to step out of my comfort zone a little bit. I want to expand my horizon. I want to learn a little bit more about myself. And I really think it is very nice to use a project like this to do all of those things. So next week there is going to be a hallway reveal video. The week after that there is going to be the unique antique video. And finally I can show you all the quirky things that I'm going to use for my living room. And if you want to follow me on this artistic, decorating, soul searching journey, just subscribe to my channel. For now, I really want to thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and I also really hope to see you in the next one. Bye!